Hi there, Michelle. Crafty Surveyings. Coming on live with y'all, or if you're watching a replay, make sure you let me know that too. But we get a lot of questions a lot of times. Most of us creators have been asked, how do we come up with our ideas? So I'm going to show you my thought process of how I came up with the idea of this angel craft that I'm making today. So come on, let me see you're out there. You may not have some of these items in your stash, but again, it's thinking outside the box and knowing sort of an idea what you want to make and coming up with it. Speaking of Halloween, I have a lot of people that are asking me about the ghost cutouts. So I am working on cutting them out today. They'll be in my Etsy shop. They're super cute and so easy for the kids to do. My granddaughters did amazing on them, and it was their idea how to paint them. So, and because they're come separated, it's easy to paint. Even my grandson with his football, he did amazing. So I don't have the football in there. I wasn't sure if I was putting that out there or not. If you're interested in that, let me know, and I may decide to do a kit with that. Okay. Now I think I'm rolling. Now I'll be able to see comments a little more. Making sure you can still
Hello,
hear
this is.
me. Perfect. All right. So you want to see my thought process? I wanted to make a angel ornament. So I combined a couple ideas together. Well, one idea, and then the rest I just came up with. So I'll show you. It's gonna be super easy. Again, you have to think a little outside the box. All right, let me show you my thought process of how I came up with this angel ornament. These are the ones I used last week, and it's starting with a process like this. Where do I got? So last week, I believe, I used a mold also from Milton's daughter, and I can get you a link if you need it, but it was a acorn and leaves mold. So I did these ornaments on a live. Okay, one is the pumpkin one though, and one is a Christmas. I did them on a live. So I'm using this concept, but I'm changing it up a little bit, and I'm not using clay today. I'm using wood. I'm using the same background, so I think I'm going to do one, unless you want to tell me. So the colors I'm using are going to be a very deep blue, and then your taupes and off-whites. If you want a different color than that, you got to tell me. We got to start with a dark color, and then I just build off of that. So the dark color isn't the important part. It's the colors you want the angel to be in the background. So if you have different than your taupes and everything with the dark blue, you got to let me know. Hello. Right, so thought process. We're doing that concept with wood. This is the background. You get these. Think they'll probably be back at Hobby Lobby again. They've been for the last couple of years. I still have them in my stash. They're probably like five or six in a pack for maybe $6.99, and then you get them always at a discount. So grab a bunch. You can use them year round. Like I said, I did that pumpkin one. So my thought process. I gotta get this out of the way. I was cleaning my craft stash a little bit, just a little bit. Couple weeks ago, and I hadn't come on live that day either. So I have a bunch of these containers I got for nothing for my son that he didn't use. And they're perfect for some of my things. So I've got two of them here because what I did was I knew I wanted to make an angel ornament. So you can see I have all my dividers and I started combining because you know how you have crafts and you have items and you don't know where you put them. This will be a easy, and sometimes you have multiple bags because you don't know where you put them. So this will be an easy way. So the way I came up with this is I wanted to make an angel, as I said, and I figured like this is a nice size. Let me get one of these up here. I thought this is a nice size head. Okay. Now I have all these hearts. Most of these wood things are from Hobby Lobby. These are split balls, but you can get them on Amazon. You can get them wherever. Hello, Sabrina. These are wood hearts. You get a big bag of them in the his and her section at Hobby Lobby. So wait till they're on sale and you get them super, super cheap. And it's a big bag. I've been using these for a long time. So we're using those hearts because I was thinking wings, but I changed my mind after I started doing things. Okay, I changed my mind. But that's what I was thinking. But we are going to use two of them. Okay, so let me get another one of these containers out. So I just sat there. I opened up both of these containers. I think I only have two. I opened them both up. And I just started staring at it and trying to figure out. All right, this is this one. What's all in here? I have clothespins, different size clothespins. These are the clothespins Holton used the other day. And if I went to found them, if I didn't have this organized, I went to found them. And I would have been buying more for them because that's just the way I am. I would have been buying more. And I got these little baby ones. Those are really super cute. These are the ones I use for those decoupage angel ornaments. I have a bunch of these little spoons. You get them now in the fall section at Hobby Lobby. I'll use them for something. You can get these at Hobby Lobby. Spools. I had some given to me. I had all this kind of stuff. So I'm just sitting here looking at this, trying to figure it out. And I came up with this. So do I want a star too? I see I have little stars in here. Let me just see. I might use a star too. My practice one, I did not use a star, but we're probably going to use a star too. Okay. So I have like several bags of these, and I use these like for my crow beaks a couple years ago in a kit. Yeah, the hearts you can use for so many things. So these are seashells in the Dollar Tree this section. So you might have bought a bag of them for something, but if you don't have these, again, use the hearts, use something different. Just look at what you have and figure it out. So I'm using two of these. These are going to be my wings. I think they're going to be cute wings. I know. And you know what else I figured out these can be when I was playing with it? Look at when you do this, you can see it better. Do you see birds? You can make this super, you could do the same thing, not as an angel, but with birds and maybe some leaves, you know, like when I did this clay craft the other day, I could have painted one of these then, maybe in the red and just added on like a cardinal or something on here. Okay. So that's how you're thinking outside the box. Hello, Linda. Oh, I hear Cash and Mr. Crafty Servings is in the house. So when you look at something, look at it differently and you'll figure things out. Okay, so we're going to use these for wings. And then when I laid it out, hello, Cash. And then I had these in here. I'm sure they're Hobby Lobby. I don't even know I got them. But these are little rings. I thought that would make a perfect halo. Hello, hon. I think that's and then the other thing is because when I was putting this together, I'm just going to take this out of here too. Yeah. I said, I think that'd be perfect. So this is how I came up with, and again, I'm going to do a dark blue with taupes. If you want a different color, let me know for the angel. Like I'm using different taupes and stuff like that. I just thought that would be really pretty. So that's what I do. So this is how I came up with it. So when I was looking what I had, of course, so I was thinking the hearts for the wings, but I changed it up because I saw these. And I thought, those are super cute wings. And this is going to come together so easy. It really, really will. Okay, I'm trying to think. I think I need my wings. I want them up this tall way. So I flipped them because there's that longer side. I flipped them. So we have upside down birds. Cash, you gonna come say hi? You're a woolly bear right now. He needs a haircut. You gonna come say hi? Can you get up in here? Yeah. You gonna say hi up here? Yeah. Yeah. He's such a woolly bear. He's so hot. He needs to be shaved again. All right. So you got that. And then I was thinking you could use the hearts for the body, which would work great. But then I thought, when I do this, so then I was looking at the hearts like this, which is really, really cute, right? It looks like an angel. My thought, though, when I was doing this is this wasn't quite tall enough. And I thought I need a little bigger, but I didn't want the head bigger. So I had these little wood discs in there that I just put on there. It's the exact same size. I think it's like a half inch. Put it in there, and that made the head stand up a little bit more. Now I think I'm going to do a star on here. I didn't in my plan, but I might. And then this works perfect for a halo. So that's how I came up with the idea of doing this. You can do whatever you have, rob your stash, know you want to come up with an angel, look at different things, leaves. I did leaves for an angel 1 year. I did for the angel body, like a large like a shelf leaner, an angel head with or an angel body with a big branch of leaves. I did that on a live big branch of leaves. It has a big round wood disc for a head. It used wheat for the halo. So those are different ideas. Just come up with, just look at what you have and know sort of where you want to go with it and see if you can come up with that. That's how I came up with this process, and that's the way a lot of us do. Use inspiration. Like I said, this was my inspiration. I started this last week. This, I believe, and I know on that live, I think it was inspiration of the soul, I think, is where I saw her doing like big round ornaments, globes, and that was my inspiration for that. So, and I'm just going with it. Okay, I want you to be able to see this. Now, the project itself will not take long at all. We got to move this. I feel like my camera is never in the right place. Just moving a little bit. So, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to be gluing this down. All right, and then we're going to paint from there. So, I'm just going to leave them on here so I have an idea where I want them. Okay. So, let's just start off with this head. I know about where I want the head on here. I'm going to use the Beacon 3-in-1. I've got hot glue here too for some in case I need it, but we'll do it from there. Right, Tina? It works. You just look. Wait till you see it all painted, and it's so easy to paint this way. So I'm just going to stick that right on that wood disc, and it just raises it maybe like an eighth of an inch, but it raised it enough for what I wanted. I didn't want to use a ball on it because I just thought that I didn't want to use a ball. All right, so the wings are going to go on like this. We're going to go ahead and put them on right away. All right, so I've got my two upside down birds for the wings. And it's also a seashell and their wings. And I used them for a crow's beak. There's so many things you can use them for. And those are from Dollar Tree. So we got that. All right. So the hearts, this one is going to be sort of stacked on top. So I need this bottom one first. And I need the placement of where I want it. So it's probably pretty good. So I'm about a quarter inch to a half inch up from there. Close. All right, so just put that on there. Then this, I don't need the glue all the way around. I just need a little bit on the tip, and I need a little down on that bottom part. So I just need probably these edges. I need my new bottle of this glue out, and we just need a little in here. I'll lay that on there. Now you can use hot glue if you want, but once you put it down, it's on. So the other thing, let's see. Just gonna shift it down just a little. See, and that's the thing is if you have hot glue on it, you wouldn't be shifting this. I want room for this halo to put on there, so we just gotta do that. So, okay, and I know I just need it pretty well on the inside here and maybe a little on the bottom. It's okay if you get some in extra places, you'll cover it with paint. Okay, just on this inside edge. And then on this bottom. Okay, that's all there is to putting that together. Honestly, that's all there is. Little extra glue in there, I'm gonna squeak out of there. There a reason you don't paint them before gluing, Gloria? Yeah, sort of. You'll see my idea of how I do this. Okay, you'll see my idea. You could paint them before. You could, but you're gonna see what I do. You're gonna see. Okay, do I want a star here? I don't know. Let me just look at my. I could put a star right at the top up there. That would be sort of cute. Let me just look on here again. We can always add the star. Oh, I like that star. Should we put the star on? All right, so the first color, I'm gonna do this again in the blues, a very dark blue as a background, and then beiges. If you think there should be another color, you gotta let me know. Put the star on. Yes, the star. Yes, the star. Okay, all right. I think if anything, I'm gonna do the star on top here. Okay, we're gonna just do that up here. And that I'm gonna do with the hot glue. All right, we're gonna put the star up there. I like it right there though? Well, it's there now. That's why I said if you use hot glue, it's there. I mean, I could reheat it and move it. Yeah, and we'll do it like that. Okay. Now I'm going to use the deep midnight blue. I just want to see how dark this is. Otherwise, I have another. You want a super dark color on the bottom because you're going to be building it up. The one I used on my practice one had gloss to it and it was pretty, but oh, here this navy is really dark too. I'm going to just put both of these on my plate and see. Oh, I do like that one. It doesn't matter what color. It really doesn't. You want a dark. On those, I used a dark gray on the background, and look at how they came out. You can see that dark gray. Me do this color and see which one I like better. Oh, I like this one. All right, we're gonna use this Anita's navy blue. These sponges. Did I bring a bag out here? I cut these up. You can get makeup sponges from places. You can get like Dollar Tree, dollar and a quarter for a bag of makeup sponges or something. These you get in the artist section at Hobby Lobby. They're only $1.49 for four of them. And I cut them all up. You could rinse them out and let them dry when you're done too. That's totally up to you. All right. Just gonna take one of them and we're gonna start coloring. Okay, now this, oh, actually, no, we're not using a sponge for this part. We're using a brush for this part. You could use a sponge, but you can't get everywhere you want to get. All right, I'm just going to use this. I don't want to use a brush that good just because it'd be sort of a waste. All right, and I'm using one that has a tip. So this is called a round brush. Now, I also want to do the outside of these. Back. And if you're going to be giving it to someone, probably want to do the back too. But I'm not doing that for this. Just get all the way around the outside, and you could get away with probably one coat on the outside. On this middle part, you're probably going to need a couple coats. It's a pretty color. So you'll see some of this color. You won't see it all. A lot of it gets covered. This is such a fun technique. It's just fun. It's so pretty. It'll be gorgeous when it's done. All right, and you want to get on every little nook and cranny that you see the wood. So somebody mentioned, can you paint it before? I guess you probably can. You probably can, but honestly, this is easy. Then you don't have all those pieces trying to put together either. And it's getting all the sides of all these pieces all at one time. And you don't have to be picky about the direction of the brush or anything. This honestly could be a little darker for me. So I could have added just a touch of black if I wanted. Just use what you have. This is all scraps that I'm using today. Or, well, scraps from my stash. Okay, and just make sure you get all those edges. I just get right underneath there. Underneath on this side, and then make sure you get inside that halo and all the way around. I know it looks funny. If you didn't see when I did those other ornaments, trust the process. It's going to be so pretty when it's done. All right, I'm just going to dry this up and then maybe give it one more coat, but just make sure you have all these edges done. Somebody asked again if they could paint it before they put it on. You can. But it's just as easy here, a little less messy. All right, make sure you're saying hi as you come on. I haven't seen comments for a long time, so y'all are quiet. But I know I've got more on here than before. So say hi, let me know where you're from. Do you have a craft stash? I was thinking actually putting this together in a kit because I have. The only thing I'd have to get more of the backgrounds. I could probably do that if people don't have all these separate little doodads like I do. All right, we're gonna give this one more coat. Let's see, I use Vanitas. Thank you. All right, so I'm just giving this all a second coat. Again, it does not matter that you're going all over the place with this. You're not gonna see a lot of the background, but you will see some of it. Just rob your stash. If you didn't top on at the beginning is where, okay. But so I had said at the beginning my thought process of how I came up with this angel. And so that's how a lot of our creative minds work, well, at least mine, is I might have an idea of where what I want to make, which was an angel. Then I had to figure out how to do it. And I knew I wanted to do with this wood ornament base. And I felt I wanted to do the same technique that I did with the clay leaves and acorns I did the other day. So I wanted to do that technique. But then I just went and robbed my stash of all these wood pieces to come up with this angel. All right, we're almost done with this whole base coat. The rest of it goes honestly so extremely fast. It's so fast, the rest of this, but it's going to be so pretty. Remember at the end, I will scroll for a happy mail also. So make sure you're commenting. I can see those comments. Always my deal is that you do a random act of kindness for someone, though, if I choose your name. That is important. All right. I think I've got it all covered. All right. It looks like a mess right now, but it will be pretty. All right. So let's just dry this up and we're going to do the next process. Like, so the next step for painting her is not hard. It's super, super easy. The first time I tried it on those other ornaments, it just went perfect. You just trust it. Trust it. It works so good. The key is to start with a dark color though. Well, welcome, Ernestine. Yeah, you caught me live, Janet. So it is important to get this part dry. And you know, when you're drying things, sometimes how your paint likes to bubble up, if you hold the gun too much in one place, you don't have to worry about that much on here. Chances are that's going to be covered. But just make sure you get all the way around. Because I'm using lighter colors on here, I'm using your taupes and whites. You want this dry. Otherwise, that blue is going to go into it. And then you've got a bluish taupe. And you don't want that. Like I said, do this any color you want. Okay. And you see, there was glue in here. And I think it is a little wet yet. I was going to say, I think it didn't matter that you still see a little, you see some glue because it's built up there, but it doesn't matter. It's covered with the paint. Now is the fun part. This is so fun. It's so easy. I don't want the blue anymore. So I'm going to get rid of that. Okay. So colors I'm using today, again, use whatever colors you like. I did a pumpkin like this with those acorn and leaves. So my background color, you want to go dark to light. So I started with the dark blue, but now we're doing taupe. So I'm going to start with this honey brown, and I'm just going to put different on here. I'm going to try and keep them in order so I remember to tell you. Okay, honey brown. Then I'm going to go to teddy bear. This is a folk art. You make me so nervous. All right, so we've got those two. So you can see I've got that on here. Then I'm going to go with, that was teddy bear. Then I'm going to go with a warm beige. This is Deco Art Warm Beige. And you're just going dark to light, so it doesn't matter that you have these exact colors, or you go a completely different color scheme. And then I'm going to do Sugared Peach. That's a deco art. And then I'm going to do a Vintage White. We are going to be using some gold, and it's like the liquid gold, and we're going to use some yellow too. So let's get this part done, and then we're going to add on the yellow last and the gold. So I won't put that on here yet. So I just put everything on here in an order. Just grab one of those sponges again. So I want a little bit rounded, I think. All right, so I'm just using that tip. And I'm gonna use the same sponge for all of these colors, and it'll just blend together. So we're gonna start with that honey brown. And let me just show you here. So I'm just dabbing that in there. You're just gonna start dabbing. Now you don't have to worry. Now I am also gonna do the edges here. You don't have to worry about getting every part of that blue. You're gonna get a lot of it, but you're not gonna get in those edges. So I'm just gonna get this in here. It's gonna look like a mess before it gets better. I'm gonna try and get that sponge a little bit in there. So that star's blocking. I might need a little skinnier sponge. I do want to get a little in there, but then we're just dabbing. And do as many layers as you like. Honestly, after this layer, I almost thought I was going to quit when I was playing with it. And I didn't, and I'm glad I didn't, but you can make it so pretty with just a couple colors. Two on the face. I'm glad you have faith in me, Robin. I'm glad you have faith in me. All right. Let me just try and get in there. I just want to get a little in there. You don't have to get all of it because, and now look at that already. So this base color, you probably do the more, I don't know how to word it. You do more the base color than you do of the rest. You're just going to start working your way down. Get some on that halo top. Okay. Now I'm going to dip into, this is the teddy bear with same sponge. No, I'm going to dry it a little bit. It doesn't have to be real dry. I just want it a little bit dry. I do want the colors to blend, but I want to make sure that I see the separate colors and not that they're completely blended. Now, I'm not going all the way to the edges with this color because I want some of that brown to show too. I mean, I'm getting a few of the edges, but I want some of that to show. Oops, the face, some up on here. You can even do a little more on the outside. And that's that layer. Now we're gonna go with, I think it was this the warm beige. Warm beige. We're gonna do the same thing. Let's just see how it's dabbing in. Okay. Just adding in that next layer. And you gradually start going more just to the center. You know, keep moving in, leaving more of the outside open. This almost looks like highlights on there. Doesn't this look old? It looks so pretty. The wings, where did you get the ornament? Okay, Judy, I am going to have you watch from the beginning for that because I did show exactly my thought process of how I came up with these angels and the pieces that I used for them, like the wings. Those were seashells, wood seashells. But it's a thought process, and you may not have that, but you might have something else. So, you know, I encourage you guys to go watch at the beginning because I went through the thought process of how I came up with coming up with this. I mean, honestly, I was going to use the hearts for the wings, but you could use hearts for the wings. You could do, it's just, it was my process of doing it. Okay, so now we're using sugared peach. It's really light color. I'm always dabbing off because I don't want like big glops of it, but we're gonna just add a little of that. We're not gonna cover everything again. You want those background colors to still come through. Okay, and the last color I'm going to use is the vintage white. I'm going to use that same sponge again. What's the last color of these taupes? We're going to add some yellow to this now and gold. Okay, so I'm just going to do a little bit of that vintage white in the middle. Yeah, I just used that same little piece of sponge. You could add some to the outside too. All right. So we're done. We're done with that color. We're done with those colors. Thank you, Judy. And thank you all for helping her out. Yeah, if you ask questions on here, I have a lot of people that'll just be so helpful in answer. All right, now I'm getting out the saffron yellow. I have a sunset gold that's really pretty too. This is pretty though. It's my two favorite colors. We don't need much of that at all. Just gonna take another little sponge. And this is how I'm doing the halo. So again, you can see why I didn't necessarily paint everything first. You know, if that answered your question. We're going to add some gold on here and a bow, and it's going to be done. That is how quick and simple this is. Isn't it beautiful? Hello, Cynthia. You could absolutely use a button for the halo. I'm going to use a button on here though. Trust me, I am. That was so funny when my granddaughter Dylan the other day, after she was done with her ghosts, she right away asked, "Where are the buttons?" And we didn't do that on that part on the live. She said, "Where are your buttons?" And she said, "I need to put your signature on." And so she put buttons on the glasses. So that was so funny. And I'm like, that just warmed me after. All right, there we go. Okay, we got that. All right, now we're going to get this liquid leaf out. It looks like a cookie. Oh, the buttons on the ghost. Weren't they cute? All right, so I'm going to have this on here just because I don't want it to spill. If it spills, it's a mess. You can get this at Hobby Lobby. It's liquid gold. Hobby Lobby, this is the classic gold. And I'm just going to go out of the cover, but look at how beautiful. Can you see that? That's actually like a paint in there. All right, let's just, I'm just going to use another smaller sponge here. And I'm going to just, I'm just dabbing in the cover. And I'm going to do around the edges. Now, can you see? Maybe, yeah, there, there. You can see that gold on there now. That's what, we're going to do that around the edges. Even the angel wing edges. If you want to use a brush, you can. I like this, using the texture of a sponge for it. Look at that wing too. Let's see if I can get it to shine. There we go. It's hard to get that with your lighting sometimes. And then I have the perfect ribbon for this color. I wasn't sure I'd like it because it's such a big ribbon, but it actually turned out really, really cute. Putting it all the way. And you can skip this step, or you can do like a dauber and do maybe a dark color around the outside of the wings and everything. But isn't that, that is just so pretty. I got a little extra under here. I can paint on that. I do want to cover that. I don't want that. Okay, we're going to put a little bit on the halo. On the face. And then we're going to put extra up on the star. He did do good, didn't he, Teresa? He did really good. All right, so I'm going to go back in and do a little buildup of this color again here. Just because I want to cover some of that gold that went in. It was too much gold under there, so we're just going to... add a little bit of color. Yeah, you don't see that gold as much. Okay. All right, and then I'm going to show you a ribbon and we're going to be done. Pretty, and when I turn it, you can see the goal. It's just so pretty and easy. Oh, you're freezing corn? I love frozen corn. I don't like the canned corn. Ribbon, where did I put it? Oh, it's right here. And then, I mean, there's all different kinds. You could use raffia. You know, I even thought it would be so pretty to use, like, a good, do like a little branch, these little branches here. So this could even be wings. Look at that, could have even been your wings. So, but I thought you could do little branches for a bowl. Wouldn't that be cute? So that would be really cute. That's Hobby Lobby. You could do like a little bit of greenery in there. I've got stuff hanging here. You could do like little green for the bowl. That actually would be really, really cute. Maybe we're going to take a couple of these big ones off and just see what we do. But I am going to do a bowl, and I think that's what we're going to stay with. Size. Okay, so you could, I said this green, put into a bowl would be really pretty on here. I'm not sure I'm going to do that though. Let's get my bow made. This is the ribbon I'm going to use. It was Christmas last year at Hobby Lobby. It's probably out there again, but get it when it's on sale, or I mean, you can get it now if you like, $7.99. It's the sparkly and it looks extra big, but it actually will be okay. Let's do... probably gonna be a little big. We might have to cut it down just a little. And then we have to add our button. Now you could use raffia too, or this ribbon raffia for doing this, for doing a bow. That would be super cute. That honestly, like you could do, I'll do two different bows and you guys can decide. Both of them are easy to do. All right, we're just gonna scrunch this up. Wrap it around. And tie it in the back. And this is wired ribbon, so we're gonna be able to adjust the way we want. Okay, let's cut that. You're not gonna see this middle. Of course, that's where the button's going to be. But look at how cute this is with that sparkle in. So we can do this one, and I will do another one with, but isn't that's so pretty in there. That it just matches so much. That's the way I did my first one. Let's just do a little bit of a bow with this, and then we'll cut the ends and just see how that looks. So oh, diamond dust would be really pretty on the wings too. It would be. It would be super cute. All right, so I do like this bow, but I thought too you could, let's see. It's pretty big though. This one's pretty big. But my thought is we could cut the loops. Trim it down a little. We'll just see what that looks like. I really do like that gold one. But something like this would be really, really cute too. You know, I'm going to do the gold just because I do think it looks super cute. And we're going to add a little button in there then too. Make this side just a little shorter. Make sure you watch later. I'm going to come out with the cutest Halloween. I haven't done one yet. I hope it turns out really cute. Even if you're not into Halloween, I think it'll be sort of cute. And there's so many different takes you can take on it too. And I'm going to be using insect molds too. I'm not an insect person, but it's going to be cute. All right. I think that's going to be really, really cute. All right. And you can scrunch this ribbon together a little more. Yeah, I love this gold too. All right, and let's just do, let's see, I'm gonna cut that ribbon a little more. Of course, my glue gun wasn't in place. All right, we're gonna pick out a button while my glue gun is heating up. It was. Okay, I just want, you know, I'm going to do these a little bit smaller yet. So I don't want to cover up the wings completely. I'm going to dovetail them too. think that'll help. There we go. And this does have a front and a back to the ribbon. So you want to make sure you've got that. Okay. We're just going to get the tiniest little button out here. My regular stash of buttons. This is the buttons my granddaughter was looking for the other day. I think we're going to use a dark one too. Although light would be cute. No, I think we're going to use a dark. All the little ones sink to the bottom in here. That's the one. All right, I think our glue will be ready. Almost ready for the random act of kindness drawing, so make sure you're commenting. I scroll names, I scroll them. All right, let's just put this in here. And it's done. All right, I lost seeing comments, but all right. There's the ornament. Isn't that just super cute? Let's see if I can get you can see the gold on it. So if you always see that better in person, but yeah, super cute. All right, there we go. So this was the same concept. So again, if you didn't see the beginning, I went through the process of how I figured out what to use for this, and I used my stash that I have here, but how I figured out how to come up with an angel, and so go back to the beginning and watch that. This is the same concept as this, where I used the leaves and the acorns last week, but we did it with wood today. So, but yeah, super cute. Let's see if we can get that gold shining again. I don't know that we'll get it. There you go. You can see some of that gold. So, all right. Thank you. We'll see y'all soon.